Murder on the Aerostar. Intergalactic Detective DaQuan had just wrapped up the case of the stolen transmats on the advanced technologic planet of Xanar in the Spiral Galaxy. King Zorelius was so pleased with DaQuan's skills that in addition to his hefty fee, the heavy-set king with the snow-white beard presented the detective with a highly sophisticated personalized tech vest. The 6-foot brown-haired detective, with the build of an athlete, bowed graciously and accepted his new prized possession. Looking forward to attending the festivities at the yearly Festival of Life on the planet Lazon, DaQuan piloted his vessel, the sleek ultra-modern ship called the Spirit, through the galaxy for nearly 2 weeks. Less than a day away from the planet Lazon, he received a disturbing call from his assistant's ex-boyfriend, Brazel.
"I'm sorry to disturb you, DaQuan, but there has been a serious incident here on the Aerostar. Someone tried to kill Jada a short time ago."
DaQuan was only half listening until he heard the news of the attempt made on his associate's life. Jada was more than just a business partner. They were good friends. DaQuan nearly jumped out of his seat.
"What did you say? Is she okay? Brazel, tell me what happened."
The Aerostar is an entertainment and pleasure ship that travels throughout the galaxy. Brazel explained that Jada was working a case on the Aerostar.
"When she got close to solving it, someone pumped poisonous gas into her quarters." Brazel went on to say, "She is alive but sedated. The doctor thinks that she will be okay. However, they are not 100% certain. And the assailant is still on the loose."
DaQuan was considered the best detective in at least a half dozen galaxies, a reputation that didn't come easy. He knew he must stay calm and focused if he were to catch the perpetrator who tried to kill his friend.
"Brazel, are you still employed in the ship security force?"
"Yes, DaQuan. I can get you authorization to dock the Spirit when you arrive. I am transmitting the present coordinates to the Aerostar to you now. Contact me upon your arrival, and I will direct you to one of our docking bays."
In less than a day's time, DaQuan had arrived at the Aerostar and guided the Spirit into docking bay 47. The sleek, glistening white spaceship doubled as DaQuan's high-tech office and home away from home. With 14 shades of light to choose from, he was able to tint the interior to suit his mood. Today, the inside of the high-tech vessel was awash in sky blue. The spaceship was more than good looks. It was very fast. In fact, the only ship faster in the entire galaxy was Nysa's Silver Unicorn. DaQuan looked over at the king's gift, his state-of-the-art tech vest. Of all the new bells and whistles, the one that he liked best was the chameleon feature. DaQuan put the brown vest on and watched it slowly blend in with the color of his cranberry-colored shirt. The vest was practically invisible to anyone who was not standing within a few feet of him. With it, he could access the ship's computer records, secretly record conversations, take photographs, make calls, and more. DaQuan was fascinated with detectives from old Earth. His favorite was Alexander Steele. He carried a small silver pulse gun as a backup, but his weapon of choice was a 9mm black Glock. Brazel watched as DaQuan emerged from the ship. Brazel had a full black beard and sideburns that were neatly trimmed. There was something about him that had always made DaQuan distrust him. Perhaps it was his beady eyes, or maybe it was his guilty-looking, "who, me?" expression. Once the Spirit had been secured, Brazel greeted DaQuan with the customary bow.
"DaQuan, I bid you peace."
DaQuan returned the greeting and immediately began to question Brazel.
"How is she?" he asked.
Brazel was much shorter and heavier than DaQuan. He looked up to DaQuan as they walked towards the main hall on Deck 10, the orange deck, one of the 37 decks of the massive fun ship.
"She has improved quite a bit since we last spoke. In fact, she regained consciousness just a short time ago."
DaQuan nodded.
"That is good news. What did she say when you told her I was coming?"
Brazel stopped in front of the door that read Infirmary. He turned to DaQuan and shook his head.
I didn't, he replied.
When DaQuan entered the room, Jada was sitting up in the bed. On a normal day, she looked more like a fashion model than a private detective. But today, Jada looked weak and tired. She took one look at DaQuan and used her hand to cover her eyes. Okay, she said. This is really embarrassing. Jada was a proud Lazonian female who never liked to ask for help. She was tall and tanned, with long black hair and a pretty smile. But on this day, there was nothing to smile about. She slowly moved her hand away from her bruised face and asked, Aren't you supposed to be at the Festival of Life on Lazon? DaQuan walked over to the bed and held her hand. There's always next year. He could tell she felt ashamed because she had failed, and ashamed that the bad guys got the best of her. Jada, who did this to you? Jada looked across the brightly lit room at Brazel. The look she gave him said it all. If it had been left to her, DaQuan would have never known of this debacle. She told DaQuan how Brazel mixes exotic drinks at one of the ship's clubs to earn extra credits when he is not working his main job on the Aerostar Security Force. One evening, while I waited for Brazel to complete his shift, we overheard two passengers talking about a time machine. One of them said that he was to meet someone here on the Aerostar to acquire the primary component that powers the time ship. Brazel thought that it was pure fantasy. He said that the passenger reeked of the drug Obvious. Jada was still in pain. She adjusted herself in the bed, turned to DaQuan, and continued her story. It was clear to me that he was on something. He probably just left one of the private dens on one of the lower decks of the ship. Anyway, I remembered the story you told me a long time ago about a guild of time travelers who are historians. The clandestine group of Lazonians who travel through time recording historical events as they occur, so that they could return to the future and correct the errors in the Hall of Records. DaQuan instantly remembered. Jada, no one knows when or where they will show up. They are sworn to secrecy so they don't pollute the timeline. The time travelers are forbidden to interact with anyone outside their own time. Do you realize the chaos and damage that could be done if just one time ship should fall into the wrong hands? Do you understand the ramifications? Brazel cut DaQuan off in mid-sentence. DaQuan, you must understand that this is no ordinary thief. He is extremely clever. A mastermind. He walked across the room and pulled up a chair. According to what I heard, this person, I never caught his name. He went to the Hall of Records on Lazon, Otar, Xanar, Deltor, and several other planets. Using the information he gathers from those records, he narrowed down the events in our timeline that would be of interest to the time travelers. Then he hired an astronumerologist to pinpoint when they would most likely show up again. I heard him say that the thief was informed by a member of Earth Guardians that they were harboring a sick time traveler. So he stowed away on the time ship and traveled back in time to steal one of their devices. Apparently, he could not steal the entire time ship, so he stowed away again once he found another ship traveling back to the present time. Jada nodded her head slowly. So you see, DaQuan, I had to go after him. I had no choice. I must have gotten careless, asked too many questions. The other day I went to my quarters and before you know it, there was gas billowing out of the vent. If it had not been for Brazel stopping by to check on me, well, I would be dead. DaQuan walked slowly around to the other side of the bed. So, what have we learned? Brazel seemed puzzled by the question. Jada quipped, I learned that I should check the air vents every time I enter my room. DaQuan chuckled. No, we learned that the transaction has not yet taken place. If it had, there would have been no reason for anyone to harm you. We also know that the thief must be asking a hefty sum for such an item, so the buyer must be extremely wealthy. DaQuan thought for a moment, then turned to Brazel. What is the itinerary for the Aerostar over the next few days? Brazel had no clue as to why DaQuan would ask such a question. But he was eager to help catch whoever tried to kill Jada and prevent the time ship from being completed.
Let's see. The ship's literary. Well, in 2 days we arrive on Galeron. After Galeron, we dock with the passenger ship, the Starlighter. Then it's on to Natropri. Why do you ask?
DaQuan smiled. Because the device is not yet on board. Neither is the seller.